that day. Now, I go on to Glentoran then. Glentoran beaten 3-2 midweek. Welcome back Paul Lehman and Pat McGibbon to the heart of the defence. Much will depend on the strike force of Morgan and Halliday. Halliday came off the bench in that Zetanda Cup to nip a goal. I would go maybe for Pat McGibbon, the number... He's number four, the centre of the defence again. And then I'll go to say the referee today, the experienced Davy Malcolm. The Blues and the Glens have met five times this season. Mr. Malcolm has been in the middle for four of them. His assistant referees today, Tommy Fairfield and Dan Steen. What I need to know, if somebody gets pointed out, if you take a look at the referees on the mound, I need to know which is which. I don't know who Fairfield is or Steen is. The two wee men, if somebody can find that out for me. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Tickets for the Zetanda match away homeward are still on sale. Price £10 for adults and £5 concession. £5 tickets helps for each of our adults. Thank you.
do. Yes, Gary, you're welcome to the Oval, young. Yes, welcome to the Oval, and Linfield today will play with their squad members on their backs. As ever, Noel Bailey in the heart of the defence, he is crucial today. The big talking point, the return of Shea Campbell. Davy Larmer, who grabbed a goal midweek, has to move to the bench. Ferguson, as ever, will lead the Linfield line. Moving to Glentoran, beaten 3-2 midweek in the Setanta Cup. They welcome back Paul Lehman and Pat McGibbon to the heart of their defence. And much will depend, too, on their strike force of the in-form Morgan and Halliday. Remember, Halliday came off the bench midweek to nip a goal for the Glens. And then I'll do the referee, obviously. He could be the referee. Look, Doc, you could be doing with him. That's not, is it? Yes, Carol. Mustache gold beard is Mr. Furfrey. Okay, thank you. Do you remember that? I'll not do any. Do you want me to commentate over this, dear, or not? I suppose we may as well, we can end it. Hard to say, there's just starting cold, like we can talk about it, you know what I mean? Here come the teams. And I can do wee clips, like just wee 20, 30 second clips, and then Gary can use it if he wants. Well, that'll be up to Garfield, yes. Great to see the crowd, isn't it? It's nice atmosphere, but at long last. At long last, you can commentate here and not hear yourself. You know? Doc and I are going to go now. Oh. Yes, what a special occasion this is, the Irish League. Hang on, do it again, 3-2-1. What a special occasion this is for the Irish League. Great atmosphere and a huge crowd for this Derby Day. And if you want to know why these are the big two, listen to this. Linfield have lost only one of their last 57 league games. And since the Glens lost to Portadown in the opening league match way back in September, they have won every single home game in the league. 13 on the trot. Lee Doherty alongside me. That's what you call consistency.
Yes, Adrian, consistency indeed, and certainly that's how you can describe both these teams. You just really have to look at the stats. But I think when it gets to this stage of the season, it's not about the stats, it's about which team's going to handle the occasion better on today. Each of them have already got a cup this year, but really that doesn't satisfy the desires of the supporters unless it's one of the major trophies. And I think more importantly for the managers, they've got a desire and the requirements for the boardroom suits.
D.B. Malcolm checks the watch, about to blow the whistle. It's Linfield who will kick off. And there we go, Ferguson touches it back. A few anxious and nervous moments for both sets of players. Ball out wide to Murphy, just pops it on up the front. And it'll be interesting to see who settles best, certainly for the Blues, who settled best in the Atlanta Cup. And there was the opening charge from Shirley King. Shirley King also scored a goal midweek in the Atlanta Cup. And at the Satana Cup during the week, I know it was a different sort of game, Doc, but it was the Blues who settled best and it was the Blues who went on to win.
Pretty much so. I think first half especially, Glentoran really didn't under the occasion. But I think the fact that Coyle will have got them working on Thursday night, coming into this game, they're now at home, so we'd expect them to perform better today.
Referee Malcolm spots the infringement. Side is Ferguson who pops it down. Opportunity here and the snapshot, that was very, very good. Ryan McCann, the man who popped up and moved alongside Ferguson. And that's the second opportunity for the Blues in the opening minutes.
Yeah, Linfield started very bright. Great shot by McCann, just going wide. Elliot Morris, I think, had things under control there. It looks the way Linfield have shaped up again. They've shaped on a 4-4-2. We weren't sure if we're going to go with three forwards, but it looks as if Ferguson and Thompson are playing up front with Campbell playing on the right-hand side.
Campbell for many of the surprise packet on this Blues team today from David Jeffrey. Not ball puff forward, Bailey, they're all in the run for it. Can tell you Muniz had to be sharp on the ball. Ricochets again back off head. Tim McCann and an anxious goal.
Very nervous moment there for Muniz. It's one of those games where you say, do I come for this, do I not? But I think he's just looking to play himself in. He wanted to get an early touch of the ball, but I think he just overextended himself there.
The pitch certainly is hard today. There's a bit of a blustery wind. Conditions almost perfect for the game, but it'll be anxious here at the very start. And let's see which team settles best. That was Lehman. He'd be pleased to get that header in against the experienced Ferguson. Lehman, the captain. And then she's again with this ball. A nice hit, another opportunity again for Linfield. Well, Ted McGinnon came across beautifully and put out the threat. Peter Thompson was the man on the move.
Yeah, I think Pat's seen that early. He's a very good reader of the game. Maybe he doesn't have the pace of some of the other defenders, but he's got a great head on him, and he put himself in the position very early to clear the danger.
So Stephen Douglas with the throw, and he can throw them long. He does so. Into the box, McGivern goes up, he gets the nudge. Shirley King again, he likes the left foot. Trying to get it across, but Nixon was the man in front. And Glentoran, well, clear their lines eventually. Struggled a little bit there to get it out. Ball swept across. Douglas this time hasn't got the control. Going towards Campbell, and yet again the snapshot.
I think maybe
from Ryan McCann, but it was a high, wide, and handsome.
I think Linfield maybe started the brighter, and it'd be difficult for both sets of players because the kickoff was delayed to 20 minutes. Players were looking to reach their peak around about 3 o'clock, and unfortunately they've had to put things back by that 20 minutes. So Linfield, I think, have just started a bit brighter.
far side, Murphy under it. He got the header. Kane pushes it forward again. But that was a well cleared by Sean Holmes. Need a little bit of play there from Sean Ward. Comes back to Morris once more. And Murphy this time lost out in the aerial battle. And Sean Ward got in front. But out to King once more. Thought about the short one, content to push it on down the line. Bailey underneath it, claims it, comes toward the captain. First time ball across, good fall for Halliday. Halliday with a snapshot. And Halliday, he's a man to watch. He's a man who can score goals. You can't give him a yard up.
That's right, Michael. I think he's got something like 30 goals this season already. And then he's half chance. The ball broke for him kindly, but tame enough in the manners. I think he had it under control.
McCann took it quickly. Ferguson pushes it forward. But the Glentoran defence. And keeper Morris alert. Good throw ball out to Morgan. Morgan flicks it out far side. A little bit too much pace in it. Lehman once more. Down the channel. Bailey watches it. Honest has Douglas. This side if he chooses to use him, but he's content, I think, this time to pump the ball deep into the Glentoran defence, but that was a good header out. Sean Holmes very forceful there. And once again, a little bit of hesitation there for Mass, and maybe the nerves getting to some of these players.
Well, I think so. Sean Holmes has a great clearance there by the head. We weren't sure before the game whether or not Sean Holmes would start to be further forward with McCann slightly behind. But he's went with Tim McCann in the advanced position.
Douglas puts it out far side. King controls it. Murphy in the overlap. Colin Nixon, a very experienced defender. Campbell pushes it out far side of Douglas. One of the features of the midweek game was his quality of cross from this side of the park. That's well worked out by Glentoran. Nice ball forward towards Halliday. Halliday under real pressure.
Yeah, it's important, I think, to try and feed ball into Michael's feet rather than his head. The Boxing Day fixture really didn't get a chance because every ball went up to the head.
Well, there's Morgan. Morgan got away. Bailey went down. Might have got a knock. Referee calls Terry Hayes on. Anxious moments for Bailey and for the Blues.
Yeah, it's not like on the stay down. Say he has got an injury, he's not that type of player that if he hasn't taken it up. Please go to the player's entrance.
You can take a look at this again here.
Yeah, I think maybe Chris just caught him with the elbow, unintentional of course, but just as he turned to make that spin, and I think he caught him all just under the chin.
You could say that, I couldn't possibly comment.
I think the intent from both teams is pretty clear, first 5 or 10 minutes. No one's going to sit and be satisfied with the draw. There's a spin, and the hand just caught Nolan to the chin. Sure at the time, but he'll soon shake that off. Of course, Chris being an ex-Blue man, he's over the office of commiseration.
Thank you. So coming up to 10 minutes gone on the clock. A couple of chances for the Blues, long range efforts. One snapshot from Halliday for the Glens. That's been the story of the first 10 minutes of this important league tie here at the Oval. Parkhurst just pushed it back. Murphy alert. Parkhurst again.
And Quiller's obviously playing Parkhurst in the midfield position today, which is quite strange for him. He's, as far as I'm concerned, he's an out-and-out striker. But maybe he's the fact that Darren Lockhart's out of that position, he's looking to add a bit more strength in there.
Ferguson pushes it back to Murphy. Had to push it through down the far side. Watched all the way. Parkhurst again. Ball kept in play. Neat football. Opportunity for the Blues to get it across. Comes back out. Murphy. Well, the wind just seemed to take it as he was about to kick it. Just seemed to bobble. And there's half a snapshot. Not connected, but Morris watches it all the way. And in the opening few minutes, it's been a game like that. It was just a case of half chances. Morgan in the chase. Morgan did well against Campbell. The home crowd loved that. That's a good ball to the Halliday, but the assistant linesman on this side. And the far side calls a offside.
Yeah, I think Michael tried the Archer's run there, but Nola just stepped forward and played Halliday offside.
Given on Ferguson, the tussle, that will be a tussle today. Parker's content just to clear the danger area, gets the header again. Ferguson had it, lost it. McGibbon moved in for the challenge, Nixon. They're throwing time to work it out of defence. Murphy again to King.
Got a bit scrappy, really. I think the pitch is very lively. The wind's picked up a bit, and I think some of the players maybe have to work on their first touch.
And Wiggy Murphy certainly keeping close tabs on the Halliday today. Here they go for the challenge, the tussle again. Murphy once more got the touch. Gavin Miller gives it back to Parkhurst, perhaps an opportunity, flicks it through to Morgan. They could bring again for Halliday. But just for a split second, it almost looks as if the opportunity might open. It must have been quite enough to put Winky Murphy on the floor.
Yeah, big strong guy, Winky. Missed a load of the season with a facial injury. Let's hope it happens around that area. I don't think so. I think it's just a case of the ball ricocheting.
He's okay, but to continue. Waiting for the throw. Alan Manis, the Linfield keeper, what a good occasion today is for him as well, too. Game number 150 for the Blues.
That's good going. An awful lot has happened to Alan in the early stages of his career. He's been kept for Northern Ireland. He's won championship medals and he's played in the Irish Cup final, so for someone of such a young age, he's packed a lot in.
Battle again for the ball, this time it comes to Morgan. Good throw from Morgan, pops it out far side. Sean Ward, faced by Murphy. Murphy won the challenge. It's been a good tussle and he was taken late. The referee will have a quiet word with Pat McGibbon as he runs by. gets through it first. Back to Halliday. Has support, pops it back. Really the ball to nowhere from Sean Ward. 15 minutes gone, only half chances. Here's Ferguson. Pops it up. Keeper well content to watch it all the way. Might have got a little knock just as he went for the ball there from Peter Thompson.
Yeah, I think Peter just let him know that he's in the game, and just a small touch. Keep on his toes.
It's a deep, deep ball. Billy underneath it along with Morgan, and Morgan was the man who got his head to it, but it bounces kindly for Alan Manis. Holds it for the Blues keeper. Side towards Thompson. Pat McKibben put that out with a little bit of interest. King once more. Looks for support, doesn't have it. Might have it with Murphy. Good hard challenge and another good hard challenge. Nothing easier than that. That was a hard challenge indeed. Yeah, I think there's one or two tackles in there.
I think it's important to the referee that he does that challenge that come in early on.
Stephen Parkhurst, the man who came in with the last one. Moments here for Glentoran. About 17 minutes gone. McCann pumps it in. Morris watches it. He goes up well. Held the keeper. Watch it all the way. Very controlled. Very good work by him.
Yeah, I think it's an easy take for the keeper. Really, the delivery has to be a bit more whip. A bit more pace on it, giving the players a chance to go in the sack.
Morgan held it up well. Appeared to be caught. Referee says play away. The challenges, yes, are coming a little bit late. Some of the fans not too happy. Tim McCann, good play this from Glentoran. Knocking the ball about very nicely. Parker McCann again in the space. Need a good cross. Oh, just when they need it. Need a good cross. Cannot be enough commanders. The ball just seemed to get off it. But an opportunity wasted.
Yeah, it's disappointing. A lovely passage of play there. One clutch football. Play from the halfway line. Great chance for Milo. Being lively as it is, he just put it behind. A bit disappointing after such good play before it.
McCann with the header, more than underneath it. McCann again into the challenge. Here he gets more good idea. Referee agrees. Certainly the challenges are going end up.
It's feisty. But that's important. I think it's important for the referee. He does let things go rather than ruin the game. Nothing too serious at the minute. But there always will be. Big two game. Challenges will go in, and you've got to compete in these type of games.
Mobile pushes it forward down towards Thompson. McGibbon underneath it. Parkhurst alert. Puts it away. But I think you'd have to agree, 20 minutes into the game, no real pattern to the game as yet.
No, it has. Things have settled down now. I've been very impressed with McGibbon. McGibbon came early season from Portadown, and he replaced a stalwart here in Gary Smith, which is a surprise for me. But I think he's proven his worth so far today. Linfield had maybe had more of the ball, more of the possession, but the better chance maybe have fallen to Glentoran.
Lost out in possession. Bailey once more pushes it towards Campbell here. Campbell under a little bit of pressure. Good chance, but he gets the ball. Breaks kindly for him. He's got men inside. Ferguson's over there, but the ball too deep.
Good long from Shea. it's a position where I don't think he's at his most comfortable. Say to me, he's an out-and-out striker. He's been asked to do a job on this right-hand side for Linfield early on. We might see the introduction of young Picky coming in later on to play down that wing. But first of all, David Foley trying to keep his shape as far as the team's concerned, and that's why he's asked Shea to do a job on that side.
Stephen Parkhouse, I'm calling him. Skitty, skew the leg for them now. He's just talking what I said, Ernest, they call it, isn't he? He play Nixon. See at the heart of the defence, Ferguson pushes it across towards Campbell. Very experienced bit of football there from Ferguson. He looked up, wasn't too much on, decided just to nip the ball back in. Beautiful ball across. It was just half an opportunity. Murphy with the head, Morgan in the chase, Billy had to get rid of it. Murphy's away, and once more anxious moments in the heart of that Linfield defence.
The Cummins is just not too sure. No, no, they are the end of each other. It's a couple of knocks Nolan's taken early on. But again, good defending. He had to take, he had no choice but to go and clear the ball. The Linfield physio, Terry Hayes, has been pretty active these first 15 minutes. He's the guy that's pushing onto the ball. Noel's running back towards his own net. And it's very difficult like that. But again, he's picked up what seems to be a nasty enough injury at the minute.
A big atmosphere, big crowd, plenty of colour, but no real incidences yet.
Not to date. We've had the one chance for Glentoran, but no one's really overcommitting themselves. I think they're just going to be taking a look and trying to keep things tight at half time.
Lehman wants the ball up to Morgan. Morgan gives it back to Parkhouse. Parkhouse with a chance. And Parkhouse with the ball. Well, we talk about the opportunity to get Torrance to Forest Group. Absolutely wild.
Morgan.
once more, the crowd celebrate.
Here we are, the shot across Monaster. Difficult for the keeper, low to his right hand side, and maybe that injury didn't help him out.
With 24 minutes gone, Stephen Parkhouse, the man who steps up to open the scoring here. He's got 5 goals this season, making half a dozen of the best, and it was a well-taken goal, but
it was, there's no doubt. And you see here, nice goal back by Chris. Shot across the goalkeeper, which is very important. And in off the post, he finds the back of the net. Good strike, not a lot of pace on it.
Now, let's see what Linfield have in their locker room. 1-0 down at the Oval, and they get current supporters ecstatic. And of course, we all know what it would mean if the results stayed this way. It would be the Glens who go 2 in front in the race for the Gibson Cup. Linfield simply have to get back in the race.
Well, that's right, it's early on. It's very important Linfield don't overcommit.
And Doc, you've been in this situation before in the Big Two. There's no way David Jeffrey and those Linfield players will panic. They just take it easy, see how they can get back into this game. Bailey's the man there in the picture. He'll try and push his man forward. You can see it already.
Yeah, there's lots of time yet. Okay, 5 or 10 minutes from the end, there might be something to worry about, but plenty of time to go yet.
Oh, Lehman, the captain. Shea Campbell. Shea Campbell got the foot in first. Lehman watches it all the way.
It's times like this when you're going to be looking to the players like Bailey and Ferguson, guys with plenty of experience, and have the rest of the players around them to show the right character that's going to need to get back into the game.
Stephen Douglas with the throw. Ferguson has it. Given Milok, nipped in. Morgan holds the ball well, Chris Morgan. Rarely gives it away up front. It's difficult enough right there in the middle of the park. Parkhouse again. And that did appear late for William Murphy. Referee again, will they have a quiet word?
Yeah, again, I think William actually pulled out of the challenge. It's a nice flick by Parkhouse, but I don't think he actually followed on through his challenge.
So Gavin Milok, Sean Holmes, the man over the ball. Milok may be the man to push it in, we shall see. Indeed he does. He's in with a breeze up the goal. Well, Pat McGinnis was up there. He got a goal against Dunlop only a couple of weeks ago. He's not noted for scoring goals, but caused a little bit of consternation in the Blues defence again.
Better delivery that time of the free kick. Give Pat an opportunity to go and attack something.
Stage. Coming up to the 30-minute mark, they lead 1-0 in this battle of the Big Two at the Oval. The Linfield fans have gone a little bit quiet. Bailey again watches it, it's deep, it'll go all the way to the keeper. He collects it, yes. That shows you there is a little bit of it. There's a sharp breeze out there, isn't there?
I think so. That was a kick from one 18 into the other 18.
The challenge is going in. Morris, which is the right far side. Holiday in the chase. The two Murphys combined, but they couldn't keep the ball in.
Linfield certainly on the back foot at the minute.
And Sean Ward, the man with the throw. Remember, the Glens lead 1-0 deep into the box. Linfield get it away, only just. And a clear nice one back for Morgan again. But the flag is up. Murphy gives it back to Bailey. And a tussle for the ball again. And your man so far, Pat McGibbon, certainly has missed very little. And the referee again, not happy with some of the challenges. He has a quiet word with Stephen Douglas. And to be fair to Davey Malcolm, he's let a few of these challenges go. As you say, he's let the game flow, hasn't booked anybody yet.
No, he started the game very well. Pat McGibbon, as you mentioned there, has been an absolute tower of strength. It's very unusual to see anyone out-jump Spike Ferguson on a consistent basis, and he's certainly done that so far. Paul Lehman pops it forward, and the ball's flicked on. Now Parkhouse certainly beginning to cause a few problems up there. Almost got the flick through to Morgan. And you can look at the crowd there as well, too, Lee Doherty. Great atmosphere, great occasion this.
Great occasion. It just reminds me of an Irish Cup final day. I suppose this is probably more important even than that. We're talking league championships here.
I thought you were going to tell the viewers about all the cup finals you played in there, Doc, at that stage.
played a lot of cup finals, lost a lot as well. Unfortunately.
Murphy pops it out far side, an opportunity for a cross from King. Well watched by McCann. McCann got it away, cleared the danger.
Glentoran midfielder working very hard, helping the defenders every opportunity.
30 minutes gone, and certainly it's Glentoran. The Glentoran defence to me looks that little bit more solid, but we shall see. Murphy almost got the Sturdy King in. It'll be a throw out there far side. Flicks it forward, opportunity to get the ball across. It goes to the corner, an opportunity now for the Blues. They'll bring their big man up, they'll bring up Bailey as well.
Bit more pressure now from Northern Linfield. They'll be looking to get a goal back prior to half time.
Murphy's up there as well. Wiggy Murphy, number three. The big men are up. Ferguson's there as well. It's a deep ball. But easy in the end for Sean Holmes to get it out. Not the cross that the blue men wanted. Good football, neat play. Graham McCann, up they go again. The ball could break down Kiley for Ferguson. The snapshot from Fergie. Very, very dangerous out there, isn't he? Just for that split second, as we said. Ball came down. Opened up a half chance.
Well, we know that's what Glenn's capable of. Although he's only actually scored one goal in the last 25 league derbies between these two teams.
That was a tad harsh.
That's my mate.
Bailey in the tussle. Murphy had a hold back. Ball comes far side. Just a little bit too much pace in it there for Tim McCann. The tussle once more. Almost broke for Shea Campbell. Stephen Parkhouse up there in the middle of the field has worked for Roy Coyle.
Well, it's certainly been justified to date. Stephen's the one who came onto the ball late from Chris and put the Glentoran team one up.
And they rise for the challenge. Need a little bit of football there from Ryan McCann. Fergie again, pops it out far side. Nixon, very experienced defender. Colin Nixon, over 350 appearances for the Glens. And their defence certainly has been very, very solid in this first half here at the Oval. McCann again. Worked very, very hard for the ball. Karevi pops it forward. Thompson tried to get it. Murphy has it. Puts it far side to King. King, this is a better cross. Danger here for the Glens defence. Ferguson gets the touch. It goes back again. The snapshot. Oh, magnificent goal. What a superb effort that was. Paul McCarevey, the man who got the split chance. And now it's an opportunity for the Lipkins of Porto to celebrate. That was superb. Half a chance. He'd be happy.
Great strength by Paul. I'm delighted for him because I think he let himself in. He knows that he let his players in the last occasion here, where he got the sending off. Oh dear, he's got himself booked for taking his shirt off.
Well, he put his head to the heavens. He said the referee to be welcome. He held his hands out. What to
Ross were. That's all the play for this game. It's like a roller coaster. Everything changes now. Linfield back in pole position, 1-1. And sometimes the big two doesn't produce the goals when we have two goals in the opening game. 35 minutes here at the Oval.
Well, now, look at the stats. I think these teams have scored something like 250 goals between them this year. So I think that's telling us there's going to be goals in this game. Let's hope we get a few more. That changes everything now. Dragging into half time, looking to be much happier after coming from behind.
Ferguson under pressure, and certainly Ferguson and Lehman and McGibbon. There's nothing else they're giving up there.
No, it's been two great contests, Lehman and Ferguson and McGibbon on Thompson. Just prior to that, I was starting to think that the Glentoran are going to stay very much on top.
Ball in deep once more, have to be alert. And they are. And Sean Holmes gets it away, but Linfield pile on the pressure once more. Douglas gets it through almost to Ferguson. Holiday might need a little bit of magic from him before the game's over. Morgan once again shields it well, controls it well, was caught, referee blows a whistle, and he just got a small flick from Ricky Murphy is going by, and a little bit of handbag and six paces between the two players, between Campbell and Morgan.
Yeah, I think Chris was getting a bit upset there, but not a lot of it.
Devon Milok, good skill, good work. Parkhouse, Connor got the opening goal. Is better. Ball comes in. Ball flicked through. Keeper has to be alert. And he was alert. And there's a little bit of stupidity between Alan Nixon and Alan Manis. What's the word you use? Feisty.
I think the temperature of the game has just risen a few Celsius.
I think you're right, Lee Doherty. It's 1-1. Every challenge now, every single fan on either side claiming it's their ball. The referee lets it play on. Colin Nixon. Murphy wants it all the way. And there we are, yet more stupidity. The referee this time may have to take some action.
Yeah, it's got a bit silly. I think players need to show a bit more professionalism this time. I know it's a game and it's something we've got very much the same control of. Here we go. Colin Nixon, Darren Murphy. Down again, very little. Colin's picked himself with the yellow card. Maybe for lifting his arm. He's more a flick of his wrist as opposed to anything else. Really.
Well, once again, he left the referee with no option. You just simply can't do it.
Well, that's right. We've had two bookings, one for taking the shirt off and one for raising your hands. And the players are professional. They know they can't get away with it.
Nixon with the throw. Certainly the temperature is rising at the Oval. Holiday gets it back. Nixon pops it forward on a skate. William Murphy, a little bit of a mistake.
Yeah.
But all the hearts pounding among the blue men.
Exactly. I don't know why that was. Wiggy got a call from Keeper and let that go. I don't think so for some reason.
Wiggy was here, mate. Linfield come again. King. Well bottled up there once more by Sean Ward. Pops it down the channel. Holiday didn't react. Murphy. Paul McAreevy pushes it on.
The game's got a lot more interesting game. Paul Lehman just got in front of Paul McAreevy there, and Paul went down. No, I wouldn't expect a penalty kick for that.
Murphy, good strong header. He'll go the whole way back to
Alan Manus. One apiece, 5 minutes to go in the first half. And the advantage this time with David Jeffrey and the Blues. Referee says, play the advantage. Jay Campbell was almost in. Murphy has option, pops it forward. Peter Thompson back to Murphy, all very intricate over there.
I think maybe both teams now will be happy to get in at the interval, get a bit of a pep talk from each respective manager.
Chris Morgan again shields the ball well, gives it back to Halliday, nipped in past the challenge of Noah Bailey. Thought he was impeded. Referee Davey Malcolm says play away. Murphy once more. Murphy's done well down that left-hand side for the Blues today. Under a lot of pressure. Alan Nixon almost pulled back. Sean Holmes content to give it to Lehman. Lehman's got McGivern inside. If he chooses to use him, decides not. This time content to push it forward. Douglas underneath it. The fans are certainly enjoying this one. Bathed in sunshine here at the Oval, and the temperature, as Lee Doherty says, certainly rising as we head towards the half-time welcome cup of tea. Sean Holmes, Kevin Milock pushes it to Morgan. And he stubs the ground. The ground's a little bit difficult for the players today. That pitch almost has the end of season look about it.
It has, very much so. There's not a lot of grass about the place. But with a player of Chris's standard, who's expecting to take that into his feet and be able to hold the ball on it.
So the clock ticks down towards the half time break. Halliday in the tussle. Milock. And here's the opportunity here. That was just before the break. The keeper did well. Would you take a look at that opportunity? Made in the start by Ferguson. Ferguson, the man who fed it forward. And that was a real opportunity there, wasn't it?
Peter Thompson, great ball, three by Spike. But again, Pat McGibbon, although he didn't get a touch, he put enough pressure on Peter Thompson just to make sure the keeper made the save.
Minutes, a few gaps in the end to appear in the game's defence. McGarvey was onto that like a shot, or Thompson was onto that like a shot. Sean Holmes on distance, and again, just in front of the kick, at the ball bobbled.
Very nice. I don't want to keep making excuses for the players, but believe me, very firm pitch. And once you commit yourself to make that cross or that strike, and it sits up on you, it can make you look like a fool. David, this stage will be maybe starting to formulate his team talk, what's going to happen in the second half along with Coyler. Any technical changes are they going to make?
Paul Lehman, the experienced captain, just flicks it off Fergie's legs, and that'll be the throw to the Glens. Douglas, good ball in, opportunity, the flick on there from Thompson. Now Douglas was particularly effective good week for the Blues in the Setanta Cup. His crosses were superb. That was a good one there.
Great delivery in. It's one of those balls where you put it in that gap between the keeper and the defender. Keeper doesn't know why to commit himself or not. Had to stay where he was. Again, good defending, just land on him a bit.
Bailey wants more under the ball. Milock got his head to it. Brian McCann pushes it forward again towards Thompson. Thompson with Ferguson. Ferguson tried to push it through. The referee still in town ball. McCann will probably leave it to Bailey, but Bailey pushes it forward again too. Referee says play away. Peter Thompson, the blue man, not too happy with that. as the seconds tick down towards a half-time break. And here is the break from the Glens. A beautiful footballer by Sean Ward. Can he get the cross in? And once again, to the delight of the Blue men, just really put the cross in. It was high, wide and handsome, and the danger averted.
Good run by Sean. Showed a lot of pace. He's a young guy that's come into the Glentoran team this year. I think he scored his first goal last week down at Ballymena. He's done very well for him, but again, I'd be disappointed with that finish.
The referee, David Malcolm, has checked his watch. There can't be too much longer left in this first half. Ferguson to Thompson. Morgan, can he get a push? Referee agrees. Billy a little bit too eager to get the ball at that stage. Perhaps the last chance before the half-time whistle. Gavin Mealock over the ball. Has men around him. Gives it back to Lehman. Lehman sees Morgan. Tries to put it across. Parkhouse, the man who got in front. And there can't be too much left in this first half. A first half that perhaps was a little bit patchy for the first 20 minutes or so, and then opened up with those two superb goals on the 24th minute and the 33rd minute. At this stage, it's a one apiece here at the Oval between these two big rivals, two teams battling it out to see who will take the Gibson Cup this season. The referee says there's still time because of injuries to the likes of Noel Bailey and Alan Manis. Here's King again in the run, pushes it forward towards Shea Campbell, with the ball will win the race to the line.
Stuart Keane's been very lively. I think he's probably been one of Linfield's best performers this half. It suits him in the left wing because he can cut inside. He's two good feet. And that was a ball through to Shea, just a bit too much pace on it.
And the referee again checks his watch. Elliot Morris with the kick. Halliday have already played 2 minutes in stoppage time in this first half. McGibbon underneath it again to Ferguson. Ferguson pushes it through to Thompson. Another opportunity here for Thompson. That's a snap shot. That was a great effort. Elliot Morris watched it all the way. A good finish to the half. Good effort. Good save of the keeper.
Same combination we had just 5 minutes ago. Another great ball through by Ferguson. Peter Thompson quick onto it. And gets his shot away.
Plenty of action in this game. As you were watching the slow motion, it was moving up on the far side as well. And the referee says, yes, there's still time to go. And that's the second time that Thompson was put in the clear by Ferguson, and Glentoran and Roy Coyle would be very much aware of that. They'll have to keep their tabs on that.
Yeah, I think so. I think Glen's, although they've maybe shaped up this at the three up front, Glenn is the one who seems to be dropping short, taking the ball to the feet and trying to release the other two forwards.
Thompson through to King. Well, Nixon had to go for the ball, but he did appear to connect with Stuart King. Purely unintentional, but there you are, as I say. Lee Doherty is scrappy enough for 20 minutes, but then it opened up with that cracker from Stephen Parkhouse on 24 minutes, in off the post, and then Paul McAreevy bounced back. The nip on from Ferguson. McAreevy left on it into the far corner. Morris got the touch, but he couldn't stop it. It could be quite a second half.
It should be, and I think both managers would be pretty happy. Both goals were very similar. Lee back from just the edge of the box and good strikes across the goalkeeper. David Jeffrey will probably be a bit more happier than Roy Coyle, because obviously the result as it suits, suits him. But we're looking forward to the second half.
They are, yes indeed. One apiece. Lots to come here from the Oval. We'll be right back after this short break.
Thank you.
Keegan for Sean Moore. Keegan for... Where's Sean Moore going? No, that's Holmes. The back is Nixon, McGibbon, Lehman, Holmes. Far side, Keegan.
Sean Ward.
No, Sean Ward's here, sorry. Ward's here. Okay. You're right, it's McCann. Tim McCann.
Yep. Welcome back, and Glentoran have already made a change in the second half with Kevin Keegan. He's in place of Tim McCann. And the goal for Glentoran in that first half by Stephen Parkhouse was goal number 3,000 for Roy Coyle as a manager of local football. And Lee Doherty, how he would wish for goal number 3,001 today to set it up for Glentoran to maybe move on and win the Gibson Cup.
Yeah, well, if they're going to be in contention next week, they're going to have to get 3,001. He's changed, and Kevin Keegan's come on the left-hand side. That'll give him more of a thrust down there. Kevin has a guy who I played with at Glenavon, a guy with a lot of pace.
Yep, one apiece, all to play for. Of course, we all know by now, if the result stays this way, it means that the Blues will stay that single vital point in front. So we shall see. And it looks as if we mightn't have a football at this stage. Some of the fans want to keep the match ball. And they signal to the bench, and here comes another ball. So somebody has a souvenir of the day.
I think so. If the score says 1-1 and Liverpool going to win the league, I think we'll see that on eBay later on.
Well, Glentoran with the early chance. The ball goes in. They're underneath it. Not cleared by Linfield. Shea Campbell in the tussle, but the Glens hold on to it. And it was Keegan there. Pulled a neat little bit of football. Down to Ferguson again. Comes off his marker once more. Gets the challenge in. Douglas once more down the far side. And Roy Coyle, the man who's made the first change in the tactical battle here today at the Oval. David Jeffrey content to sit with the 11 he put out in the park at the very start of the game. Here's Douglas again. Stephen Douglas, this man can certainly push them right in towards the box. Over to the far side, the keeper passes under it. Willie had a stretch, but he did well. Very competent keeper.
Daniel Douglas has been going to get underneath that there. A tremendous throw in by Douglas.
Just too close to the keeper. That was King who pushed it forward. Murphy once more, very impressive in the first half, Darren Murphy. As was that man, Pat McGibbon. Ball on the park, Halliday under pressure. Parkhouse pushes it forward in towards Chris Morgan. As the Jets come reeling in overhead. And here's the cross when I come reeling in overhead. We hope that once again, the ball bubble. A little bit of sympathy there for Sean Ward, but there's too many chances that got being wasted by too many players.
Yeah, I think so. Sean has actually played very well. For many times I've seen Glentoran this year, he's been playing in the right back position. A bit more advanced today. Maybe a position that's unaccustomed to him, but he'll be disappointed with that delivery.
Alan Manus. A huge kick out from him. Shea Campbell nips inside, under pressure, still has it, beats one, beats two, still has the ball, loses out. Tussling for the ball with Milok, the two players go down. The referee, Davy Markham, right over the play, right over the players, certainly not allowing any nonsense to develop there.
Mr. Malcolm has been very impressive today. Hasn't got too many decisions wrong to date.
And has kept a level head in the game, has spoken to the players, has ticked them off and had to. But here's Ferguson. Oh, just slipped at the vital moment. And Pat McGibbon there once more to pick up the pieces. And Murphy lost out in the header there to Sean Ward. Douglas, this time once more with interest. They're underneath it, back to Douglas. Just couldn't get the ball through. Margarivi pushes it out far side. But a scrappy enough start to the second half. And you look at the likes of Roy Coyle has made the change with Keegan, and you wonder now, will David Jeffrey at some stage respond, or is he quite content where he is at the moment?
He'll certainly sit at the moment and be very contented. The thing is, the 1-1 result is a result that he'd be more than happy to go away from the over with.
Referee Malcolm says that Milot was a big in that challenge. For McAreevy, the man with the left foot who'd swing this one into the danger zone again. Morris alert, as ever, it comes deep, he gets it back. And that was a goal line clearance from Paul Lehman. Came right on the far side, that was a real opportunity, that could have been 2-1. And still they come, King pumps it in once more, they're underneath it, Ferguson got the header. This time Morris able to pick it up, gets a little acknowledgement from Paul Lehman. But that was a chance.
Great ball in again, McAreevy. Looked as if it was going long, but I think it was William Murphy who came back, hooked the ball across. Good defending by Lehman.
Another goal mouth opportunity, another goal mouth incident. In the game has produced a few. Here's Bailey once more, watches it all the way. And Manas looks to be that little bit more comfortable, a little bit nervous in the opening stages, Alan Manas. Seems to have settled himself now. That's the high ball once more with the far side, once more Sean Holmes underneath it. The Glentoran defence has been very steady, indeed all the defenders have been very steady today. But Pat McGibbon, for me, as you say, Lee Doherty, has been the jewel in the crown so far. But it's one apiece. It'll have to be under pressure. Ferguson underneath it. Well, you know, it's a little bit lax there. You know, Paul Lehman gave Ferguson just that half a yard, but it proved to be dangerous before the finish of it.
Yeah, it's whether or not the shot came in from the goalkeeper. And Paul Lehman didn't seem to go and attack the ball. And he let maybe Glenn muscle him off it a bit.
And the buzz begin to build again with the crowd. A long throw once more. Ferguson underneath it, waiting as always, just willing to pounce on any little mistake. Douglas.
Both managers will be disappointed with their team's final delivery. There's been a lot of good interchange, good passing, quick 1-2s in around the midfield area. But as soon as the ball goes wide, unfortunately, 9 times out of 10, it's going over the back of the net.
Stage, but the gap's beginning to appear.
I think the strength of Linfield have at the back is the pace and hope. Bailey.
Morgan, good ball back into Nixon. Can he finish it? Nixon with the ticket on! Yes! Oh! What a mistake on Linfield defense. They were so hesitant. Beautiful work by Morgan. Saw him coming through, flicked it back. Nixon kept his head, and boy, did he pick his finish. 2-1 to the game.
He'll be over an awful long time for such a young man. Probably wasn't his cleanest strike he's ever hit with his left foot. Might be a bit of a swinger. But a coach Glentoran back in full position in the 3 points at the minute. Here we are. Great flick by Chris Morgan. Colin Nixon comes on to it. Not the best hit. Might have deflected, I'm not sure. Like, look at that from behind. Here we go. No, straight through down Murphy's legs and trickled into the net. All to play for again. Linfield are going to have to start pushing a few men forward. Another chance.
And here come the Danes again. Morgan. Team lead 2-1, and the Blues, if they're going to take take the Gibson Cup again. They're going to have to come back and do it the hard way. 1-0 down after that goal from Parkhouse. Then McAreevy get back to make it 1-1. 1-1 get in at half-time. And then on the 53rd minute, next Amanda Stalwart for the Glens. And you can see a little bit more... A little bit more activity, let's say, from the Blues. They know they're behind it. They need to get back into this one.
Yeah, they've got to start chasing the game now, Linfield. And probably 30, 40 minutes left in the game, and David will have to be maybe thinking of making one or two substitutions.
The referee, maybe Malcolm. Some of the players, and indeed some of the fans, aren't too happy with that. But the referee, to be fair, just 2 yards of play. Just says, settle it down, lads. Let's play away.
Yeah, he hasn't missed too much, David Albers.
Side for Thompson to run with the ball, they just skids away. And even at this early stage, you can look to next week. Both teams, when you think about it, Linfield, they have to play Cliftonville, Glentoran have to play Crusaders. No easy games left in the league, but I tell you what, Roy Coyle would dearly love to get the 3 points here. We talked about that goal number 3,000. Well, probably very apt that it was Colin Nixon who got his goal, 3,001 for Roy Coyle. Nixon, one of the great stalwarts here at the Oval. A defender of real polish and class, not noted for his goal scoring, but he certainly popped up there, and that's one for the scrapbook, one for the memory, and one for the video reporter. Back through to Morgan. Morgan put on, we're finishing, they can make it 3. Oh, poor finish. That was a poor, poor finish. Chris Morgan loaded, he was through. He seemed to hesitate just the rest. The ball seemed to hold back for him. Unadmanished game, didn't know what to do. Should have done better.
Nice touch from Michael Holliday. Loved the ball through. Chris, on his weaker foot, thought he was going to lob it, but then it was a shot across the keeper. Pretty team. Chris has actually hunted Linfield a couple of times.
Gavin Maylock. Push it back out to Paul McAreevy. McAreevy to Campbell. Campbell has support. He chooses to use it. Loses it. Morgan here has it. Has it back once more. This is good play from Glentoran. They're in the chase. Well, that was Kevin Keegan. Very, very fast. Very nippy player. And Linfield need to settle their heads a little bit here.
They do. Keegan there just using his pace. And it's as well. It was Winky Murphy, who's equally fast. Came across to cover the danger.
The problem, I suppose, for Linfield is that they will have to go searching for the goal and at the same time be careful not to leave themselves open at the back where they left themselves a little bit exposed there too late.
Yeah, but that'll happen as the game goes on. Linfield will have to overcommit, and because of that, the fullbacks will maybe lose shape and lose position. That'll give the opportunity for the two Glentoran front men to run into those channels.
Ferguson, he has support, goes out far side to Shea Campbell, can he push it across? He can. But Paul Lehman again, as always, very, very stout, very, very strong in the centre of the defence. Douglas in the chase, Douglas loses out. That was a chance against there for the Blues.
And here we'll have a change coming, and it's maybe one back at the bee. Picking coming on for Shea Campbell.
Yeah, the man who just crossed the ball there a moment ago to set up a chance for Linfield, replaced by the very, very experienced Mark Picking.
I think Shea's done the job that David asked for him. He worked up and hard down the right-hand side. But there's going to be more of an end product, I feel, that'll come off Mark Picking. He's a bit more direct, he can commit people. And really, at this stage of the game, Linfield need to be creating chances, and Mark Picking's the guy that'll be able to do that for them.
To go, and Linfield again being pressed. Nixon, the goal scorer. But once more, well,
even I know Paul McGreevy's skillful, but I really don't think he meant to flick that back to the keeper.
Even the staunchest of Glen supporters wouldn't call that a flat back. There's Picking. First chance into the fray. Well, that was a hard challenge there.
The first Picking in the game today.
Stephen Douglas. He's called back by the referee. Pat McGibbon, not too happy.
Yeah, oh dear, foot up. Caught him round the hip. I suspect this will be at least a yellow card. Again, Davy Malkin taking his time, not fussing over it, doing the right thing, trying to calm things down. And here we go, the yellow card.
Yep, yellow card. A little lecture for young Douglas. So 30 minutes to go. Mark Picking certainly the obvious change and the obvious choice there for David Jeffrey.
I think it's important that Linfield keep their discipline. I know things can get very frustrating, but there's still plenty of the game left. You've got to keep control and look to get into wide areas. So we'll have supply for the likes of Ferguson and Thompson coming into the box.
And when you look back at the second period of that first half, it was Ferguson who was opening up the Glentoran defence, pushing it through to Thompson. And Thompson actually could have made it 2-1 just before the break.
Yeah, I think we'll find Glenmore in an advanced position now. He's went up, then twin centre forward with Thompson. And the width of them come from Keane and Picking.
Noah Bailey, McGibbon again. Just goes about his business, but McGibbon looks very, very fit, very fresh today. Nixon. Good work once more by Sean Ward. But Pat McGibbon has just gone through his game, hasn't been flustered, just played away and kept the throw.
Yeah, I think the whole Glentoran back line have been very impressive.
Here's Ferguson, has support from King, takes it himself, gets it back to Murphy. Murphy thread across it once more. Sean Ward, the man who was in front of him, causing the obstacle. King once more. Does well to get it out. Murphy pops it forward. Lehman with a header. Paul Lehman has done well too, the captain. Vastly experienced player. And Milok content to put it anywhere. Morgan picks it up. He's got men out far side. He chooses to use them. Well, it was almost a good ball through to Keegan. McAreevy once more. The Blues men exhort their men forward, looking for the equaliser, looking for that vital goal. It's 2-1, but that's poor play. And the opportunity again here for the Glens to break. And that's Keegan. Can he get the cross in? He can, and towards Morgan. Morgan goes up. Well, all it needed was a touch. We talked about Linfield trying to move forward, trying to get the goal, and being a little bit exposed at the back. Perfect case in point.
Yeah, I think we'll see that happening more and more even as the game goes on. Linfield have no choice. And it's really winner takes all here today.
Yes, it's almost the fear of losing, the fear of winning. Let's put it whatever way you want to use, whatever you want to say. But been great efforts.
See another substitution. Aidan O'Kane. Aidan O'Kane coming off from Stuart King.
Aidan O'Kane comes in. Stuart King goes off. And Big Davey brings the changes and a bid to get back into this Big Two derby.
Again, quite surprising. Aidan O'Kane's more of a narrow type player as opposed to someone who'll give the width to the team, but maybe he's hoping the supply will come from Mark Picking.
Let's see. Ryan McCann. Back to McCann. McCann's got the space to put it in. McAreevy. Tried to put onto his left foot. Referee says it wasn't unfair. And the ball breaks kindly for Nixon. Morgan on the run. This near side. Halliday through the middle. Nixon content to hold it. Pushes it down the far side, but Morgan had come back. It'll be huge disappointment here for the Blues fans if they don't get something out of this game. And huge, huge delight for Glentoran if they can hold on to this scoreline. 2-1. That would put them 2 points in front in the race for the Gibson Cup. What an end of season it is.
Well, that's right. It puts everything back in their own hands. They can dictate their destiny. And that's the only result that will do that for them today. They need the 3 points.
Nixon, under no real pressure.
The one thing I would say about the substitution with Aidan O'Kane, he scored some marvellous free kicks this year. I think he's got about five or six from 20 yards out, dead ball situations.
And that could be another reason why he's in there. Ferguson holds it up well. Gets it out to O'Kane. O'Kane with a cross, good cross, up they go. And this time it's Glentoran struggling a little bit in defence. Oh, just didn't work for Darren Murphy. Made the right choice, 20 minutes gone in the second half. If it had got that cross and gone in, you never know.
Yeah, I think he failed to make the cross. Shaped up with his, if he was going to whip it in first time. But his first touch was fair first touch.
Overall, at this stage, Lee, would you agree 20 minutes ago that perhaps Glentoran just about maybe have shaded it 2-1?
It's been very tight, but I think maybe they're just edging at the minute. Linfield, I would expect, for the last 15, 20 minutes, will start applying a lot of pressure. Glentoran really need to be a bit more composed. I think at the minute they're just looking to clear the ball, no matter where it's going straight back.
Thompson was the man who tried to open up the defence again there. And as you say, with 25 minutes to go or so, you can imagine it with 15, 10 minutes to go, Elliot Morris, anybody at the siege of the Alamo, I would have thought the last 15 minutes in this one. But here's Douglas again, the long throw specialist. McGibbon underneath it, watched it all the way, timed it, run O'Kane in the challenge, didn't work, comes out to McCann. McCann back, ball goes in again, the flick on from O'Kane. And that was Thompson in the run, but the keeper is ever alert. And if these two teams have been the two best teams in the league this season, you'd have to say they've been two of the best keepers as well.
Yeah, I think so. I think when you're looking at the two best teams, you look at defensive records. And these two teams are way ahead of every other team in relation to goals conceded.
And Noel Bailey again, all the experience, just called for Manus to come and collect the ball. A high challenge once more. And once more the pressure builds from the Blues. Over on the far side, Douglas. And that was Mark Picking who got the corner. And this is the chance. The big men will go up now for this one.
I think the field have everything in their favour at the minute. They're attacking the end where their supporters are. They've got the win behind them. And they know really what they've got to do. They've got to go seeking that equaliser.
Almost 22 minutes gone. The ball goes in. Another opportunity again. Once more the deep ball, it's beaten Morris, they're trying to get it at the back, but it goes too long. So 22 minutes gone in the second half. He tells Elliot Morris to get on with it. David Jeffrey has played a couple of aces, hoping for his side to get back into it. It'll need a little moment of genius, a little flash of brilliance from someone. So far we've had three magical moments, two of them for the Glens from Parkhouse. Look to be a handball. Referee says play away. Oh. And yet another little bit of stupidity. Player is down.
Yeah, I think Parkhouse went down pretty easy there. That's Davey Lorimer. He looks as if he's going to...
Back to the action, Glentoran's ball in, an opportunity here, but falls! A little bit of frantic defence there from him.
Good defending.
Just for a second, Sean Ward almost had it, but he still recovers, gets the ball back. Parkhouse controls it well, puts it across out here towards Milok. No, ball goes wrong. Linfield may make the change now. Davey Lorimer could be the last of the substitutions, but this is the last throw of the dice for Linfield.
Darren Murphy's coming off, taking off a defender for a forward.
Meantime, Big Davey has a word with Aidan O'Kane. Davey Lorimer, a man who nipped in for a goal in the Satanta Cup, the opening goal on Tuesday evening. A little bit more from him, as we said. The Glens defensive could be the siege of the Alamo in the last 10, 15 minutes.
It looks like it. David has now got his three recognised front men at the top end of the pitch. But I don't think he's much choice. He really has to go for this.
Chris Morgan. Good play, Morgan. Faced by Bailey. Still has it. Gets the cross and good ball in. Halliday. Almost got the flick. We look in the chase, but it's Picking who picks up the pieces. Down to Lorimer. Lorimer, neat ball back. This is better football from the Blues. Oh, that's beautiful football. Superb stuff.
passage of play there by Linfield. We've seen Chris Morgan put over a super cross where Michael Holliday had a chance, but Linfield very quickly on the break. Douglas with the throw, thought about the short one. This time pulls deep, gives it to Davey Larmer, gets the flick on. The crowd's a call for handball, wasn't anywhere near it, and the danger is cleared. But there's a beautiful passage of football, a beautiful break.
I was actually quite surprised Davey Larmer didn't start the game. He's been a rich goal scoring Fianna Fáil. I think he scored maybe five or six over the last seven or eight games.
Double figures already in goals this season too, and as we say, he got that opening goal in the Setanta Cup and proved a real handful on Tuesday night.
Yeah.
At Windsor. How would you put it? With 20 minutes to go, it's delicately poised.
There's no doubt it's still very much on the knife edge. Glentoran have got to say, well, do we go for the third and try and wrap the game up?
Or do they hold what they have? Here's Davey Larmer. They might have to hold out for another bit. He's got picking and support. But Larmer tried to flick it through, but that was good work by Sean Holmes. But it comes to picking once more. A lively player. Can he get the cross? And he can. Header comes out. Here's McCann once more. Back to picking. McCann once more. The pressure is intense. Comes out deep. They get the flick on. Very cool collective play from Paul Lehman, the Glentoran captain, totally on top of the situation. Nixon looks for the runner, he has it. Morgan just appeared to be hustled off the ball.
Yeah, I think that's going to be the pattern of the play over the last 15 minutes. Linfield having lots of possession, punting balls into the box, and Glentoran defending for their lives, and hopefully for Glentoran's point of view, to get them on the breakaway.
Devon Maylock puts it forward towards Halliday, and that came off the Linfield defender. Yes, Douglas was the man who was the most alert, and that's been another corner, and yet means more pressure for the Linfield defence, and this is the wrong end of the park as far as D.B. Jeffrey's concerned.
Yeah, Roy probably wants to slow things down, get the tempo of the match just to drop a touch.
Corner comes in, the keeper underneath it. Oh, he does well. Manus does exceptionally well, watched it all the way, made it his. Noel Bailey and Maylock in the challenge. Maylock got the final little flick on. The throw goes in favour of the Glens.
Again, I think taking their time now, Sean Holmes. Just trying to slow down the pace of the game. It's very much in their favour to do that.
And referee Davey Malcolm, like the players who've experienced, he goes over and he says to them, could you please hurry it up a little bit as we approach 28 minutes gone in the second half. 2-1 to Glentoran. The Gibson Cup in the balance, beautiful skill. Can he get the cross? It goes for the throw. Halliday does well under pressure there from
this will suit Glentoran. Linfield need the ball at the other end of the pitch, and this is very much playing in the Glentoran's hands at present.
Yep, eating up the minutes, eating up the seconds. If they could nip a third, it would really put Linfield very much under pressure. Back out to Ferguson, timed his move for the ball, pushes it out far side. Maylock watched it all the way. Puts it across towards Morgan. Good skill, Morgan. Takes it. Good control. Has support. Elects to go himself. We might look for the corner. Put a poor ball in the end. But it's at the wrong end of the park as far as Linfield and the hordes of Linfield supporters are concerned.
Yeah, a couple more minutes wasted up. Again, Chris has taken the ball well into his feet. But unfortunately, the final really wasn't what he was hoping for.
Alan Manus deep again. Ferguson once more, always eager, always showing for the ball, and this time he gets the free kick is for his reward. And once more, Wiggy Murphy goes up. And off camera, Noel Bailey checks for the bench to see how long's to go. But we can tell him there's around about 15 minutes to go here, just on 29 minutes. That's Ryan McCann. Free kick. Morris shouting instructions. They're all in there.
picks it through up the goal. McGivern again underneath it. McGivern has missed very, very, very little in that Glentoran defence.
This gives Aidan O'Kane a chance to whip the ball on his left foot. Now he's going to let Ram McCann take it.
So let's see what Ran will do. He'll try and swing this one in to cause as much problems as he can in that Glentoran defence. What would Linfield give now for a goal? Oh, gives it O'Kane. O'Kane left for it. That was good alert play all the same by Sean Ward. Ward's done well in the second half. He's broken up a lot of the play down this side of the field.
He has. He's more a defensive player, although he's been playing in midfield today. Sean Ward is very much a defensive player.
The corner comes in. Next on alert. Pops out again. Not possibly the wrong option. He had men in support behind him, so he had McCann. Didn't see it. Didn't use it. 15 minutes to go. Glentoran lead 2-1. If it stays this way, they will go 2 points clear at the top of the Daily Mirror Premier League. Well, let's see. Davey Larmour in the chase. And the ball goes the wrong way. And the opportunity missed, wasted.
Yeah, it was very much just a pump down the middle. I think Linfield really do need to get it in the wide areas so they're getting behind the defenders. Gave the forwards a chance to actually come onto the ball.
And Lee, this is where the experienced players, they come into their own. They're going to have to talk to these younger players and tell them not to panic. There's still time. Keep playing the ball. Keep looking for the opening and don't panic.
Yeah, I think so. I can see Glenn Ferguson in the midfield there. He's trying to direct the play. He's trying to get people to get into wide positions.
Paul Lehman. Ferguson in the clear. Beats the offside trap. He's got Halliday. Halliday faced by Douglas. He gets it right in towards the front part, and that certainly wasn't the cross we expected. I think we all expected one to the deep. He cut it in front, they got it, Halliday almost got in there.
Ball in. Michael Halliday knows that's the type of run he'll be looking for, just didn't get across the defender of the keeper. I think Chris tried to pass that in. I think that's maybe the option you're going to have in this bumpy pitch today, as opposed to striking David and Bram McLaughlin. I think we're getting to the stage where, what can we do? We've used our three substitutions. We're going to have to switch whoever the personnel we have on the pitch. What changes can we make? I know what this football club means to David Jeffrey. He's been a Linfield player, now he's been a manager for so long as well. He lives and breathes this club.
David Jeffrey has won 3 league titles with the Blues. Look to repeat it again this year. Pierce Ferguson, maybe he could get a bit of magic. Here comes O'Kane. Well bottled up there in the defence. That's good defensive work by Glentoran. Battling very, very hard for the ball. It falls for Thompson. Thompson gets it far side of the Larmour. A little bit frantic, but certainly worrying times too as well for Glentoran. Blues continue this relentless pressure. Just about 13 minutes to go at the Oval. They trail 2-1. Linfield need a goal. Noah Bailey pops it back to Manus. Difficult enough for a bouncy tip. Get the ball, could have gone anywhere.
Alan will not thank Noah for that type of pass back in a pitch like this.
At this stage of the season and at this stage of this game. McCann battling hard. Armour, good pitch out, picking with a cross, and underneath it, Morris comes out. And the keeper does well. He may have hurt himself on the hard ground as he came out.
Well, I don't know. I think it's maybe just a case of okay, let's go. Another couple of minutes. Oh, maybe not.
We shall see. The ball is away.
Here we go. Great cross by Mark Picking. Ferguson coming in. No, I don't know if there's much in that. I think he's maybe just sending himself away just a couple of minutes. And why not?
Dare I say it, in your time, you probably would have done it yourself.
I think we all do. Anyone who's played this great game of ours, and you're holding on to the chance to win the league championship. Not so much that you're breaking any rules. You just take advantage of the situation. And if you have to kill a few minutes, then so be it.
He's done it all, he's won all the trophies, he's played at the highest level, handing out the instructions for the last, what, 10 minutes or so here at the Oval. What would victory mean to him today?
Roy Coyle's the type of guy that's been there, done it, wore the T-shirt on numerous occasions. He knows what it takes to win championships. He was fortunate enough to be in his team when we picked up 8 championships through the 80s, 8 out of 10. So if anyone knows how to win a championship, it's certainly that gentleman, Roy Coyle.
Elliot Morris fit to continue. And some of the Linfield supporters begin to make their way to the exits with 10 minutes to go. Some of them have seen enough. And for my money, they're a little bit premature. Picking under pressure from Keegan. Picking still has it. He's in the clear. He's straight through. There's an opportunity. Can he bring it back? Well, that was a good challenge in David Larmer.
Run again by Mark Pickett. I think that's really where the supply is going to come from. But let's give credit to Glentoran back for today. It's been immense. Pat McGivin, Paul Lehmann up against the strikers of Thompson and Ferguson's caliber. It's been superb.
So 10 minutes to go. Linfield, what would they do for a goal? A simple act, a goal that could change the entire season. They trail 2-1. Some of the fans leaving a little bit early for my money. I think there might be something left in this game yet.
Yeah, I think so. I think that's just the difficult nature of this game.
Thompson on the turn. Lehman gets it out. Only as far as O'Kane. O'Kane stretch, couldn't get it. Keegan puts it out deep towards Halliday. Bailey underneath it. Flicked on by Picking. Keegan held it well. Hard tackling out there. Everybody wants the ball. Thompson was in the challenge. Well marshaled there too by Paul Lehman. Lehman and McGivin have been, as Lee says, immense this day. Douglas puts it in. And there goes McGivin once more. Made the call. Milok comes out to Morgan. Oh, neat ball through to Milok. Good run by the midfielder. He has a Halliday on his own. Morgan's run was halted. He has Nixon.
Yeah, he just delayed a wee bit too long there. Colin Nixon made a superb run on the right-hand side of him. He really should have fed him through a bit quicker.
Davey Larmer got his head to it, which is in towards Ferguson. The opportunity for Picking in the clear. Oh, the ball just seemed to bubble up for him. Couldn't get out of the log, but couldn't get out of the shot. But you see Pat McGivin, he's not happy with his defence.
Yeah, I think that was a chance there, Mark. You really don't get that much time in the box. Set up for him. Took a shot, but well wide. He's the guy, of course, who won the championship for Linfield last year, Mark Picking. Scoring the all-important goal against Glentoran to lift the title then.
And of course, we also have to remember, too, that the championship is not decided here today if this scoreline stays the way it is.
Yeah.
But it'll have a major, major sale.
Yeah, try telling the managers that. And the players, I think. I would be very surprised if whoever went on to if it's a draw today or Glentoran win that they didn't go on then and win the championship next week.
And of course, after this one, then the focus will all go to Cliftonville and Crusaders, where both teams have to go to next week.
Well, that's right. Glentoran go to Crusaders. A friend of mine, Stephen Baxter, who's managing and doing a great job down there. They're fighting for their lives, so it'll not be easy. But I would still expect if Glentoran had to go to Seaview next week for 3 points of the championship, they'd do what was required. This is the frustration thing about football. We've got to this stage of the season where Linfield, I think, have lost one league game all year. And they've sat proud at the top of that table for so long, and it can be snatched away from them right at the penultimate game of the season.
But I even read David Jeffrey today in the morning papers where he talked about the fact that they had gone on an incredible run, Linfield. But it being Glentoran too, who had done so well to stick with them, only a point between them. Well, here's the opportunity, the snapshot, and the goal! Scripps, we hope that you'll...
your answer at the minute. Give a runner to another blue man through and through. You can see what it means to him. Well, you see what it means to them as well too. 6 minutes to go. Glentoran seem to be well on their way. Here we can see it again.
Nice touch again. Great strike. Oh, it's David Armour. Out and out predator. Give him a chance. 9 times out of 10, he'll put the ball in the net.
And you can't blame the keeper. It just went before.
No chance.
Good goal.
You say those fans who have went that bit prematurely?
Yes. Now it swings back the pendulum. What a man. Morgan. Barkhouse. Wheelock puts it through. Keegan. 5 minutes to go. Picking their fight. They'll scrub for every single ball.
You're in. This is true drama. It just doesn't happen like this on a football pitch. It's not meant to.
You need to check your heart at this stage.
I'm trying to stay as impartial as a couple of can.
Yes, it's difficult to this. The game's all about the local game. Very, very important. 2-2. Been at both sides. Been a great advertisement for the local game. Up it goes. Halliday in the flick. It's still in the box. It's not cleared. The chance for Halliday. Nixon's there. Oh, Pennyworth will do. And we talk about one end being the Alamo. It could be the Alamo here, the far side now to the Blues.
Completely switched the scenario.
Is there another goal? Is there a fifth goal?
I don't think we've seen a lot so far. It's going to be a frantic last five minutes, plus whatever the ref's going to add on. I'm sure it's what this type of crowd deserves. You know, we're talking 10, 12,000 people in here today. But okay, the football at times might have been the prettiest. But what a spectacle. You see the effort and the commitment from both sets of players. An absolute credit to the club.
It's a funny game, you know. The game on occasion might not have the greatest quality, but at the same time, again, a huge drama, great excitement, and some magical moments. We've had all that here today, and we've had 4 magical moments, from the opening goal from Seaward Parkhouse to Michael Reeby to the equaliser, to Colin Nixon, and again, Linfield have to come bouncing back again. They've done it twice. You talked earlier in the week in the football, or earlier this season, the football show, but here's Halliday. Says when we talk about it in the football show, you say that Linfield and this spirit, this driving effort, that they just wouldn't lie down. They haven't lied down.
This guy they have beaten him, David Jeffrey. Had the pleasure of playing with David at Linfield. I know what type of character he has. I know he can still have his player. He would certainly not accept anything less but 100% of his player. I think not only has David got that, I think Roy Coyle is ready, has also got that from his player.
Wow, what's left? Is there another twist in this drama?
David Hart had some heart scars early on the season.
2-2. At this stage, the Blues stay tantalising 1 point in front in the race for the Gibson Cup. Is there a goal in it left for Glentoran? They lead 1-0, 2-1. They go again. Good ball in. The keeper has to be alert. It's right in. Superb defence again from midfield, and once again an Aver will do. Lee Doherty, what a finish!
Great flick by Sean Ward. I don't think he's seen. There's Michael Holloway, got a touch in. Wiggy Murphy, oh, great positional play by the centre-half. That's why Michael Holloway has scored 30 plus goals this season. He always finds himself in the right position. I think it was just unfortunate that time that Wiggy Murphy had to get back on the line.
Well, what tension, what drama. And Wiggy Murphy, he'll say it was good positional play. It was very alert from a defensive point of view, but here's the opportunity for the Glens. They have the corner. Can they get a third? They're all underneath it. They get the header. And Davy Longer. Down the Donegal Road will do for that ball for Davy. But the Glens still battle on.
Now it's Linfield's turn to try and kill the game. Slow it down, take a few seconds, precious seconds away. I think now the choice David has is, do they go for the winner and win the championship on the day, or will they accept it for next week and win it then?
Yeah, at this stage you would accept, you'd have what you hold at this stage.
I think so,
and
maybe.
Just hope for it. Here's Wiggy Murphy, the man who's a defensive appearance there, could possibly have saved the day for the Blues, Davy Larmour. What a change he's made. And to be fair, we talked about Roy Coyle picking his team, doing tactically very well. Davy Jeffrey made the changes and they worked.
Yeah, well, at this stage anyway, it's working for David. There's been so many twists and turns in this game that we could have anything. You know, we've got 2 minutes to play. We've got out of time to play.
Back to the Irish for Pete's little thing here.
Great football game in this big crowd. But when you're the manager or a player, you're on there. Very bad for the Irish.
So we're coming up to the 45 minutes. The last 20 seconds of it is 2-2. The Blues came back from a 1-0, a 2-1. It's two apiece.
There hasn't been a lot of stoppage in this second half, so I would expect no more than be 2 minutes.
Ball driven in. Nice flick. The Glens come again. They know they haven't got too long left. They've got Milok out far side. Good play by Milok under pressure. Referee said he was impeded.
Spike kicking the ball away there. Fortunately enough, he didn't. Maybe he wasn't noticed by Gibby Malkins. Experience from Ferguson again, just trying to kill a few more seconds.
The ball in deep, Halliday underneath it. Halliday got the flick!
Super shape by Manus and Chris Morgan. That's what it's all about, being a striker. Be in the right position. Get yourself positional wise right and the ball will find you.
Oh, we're back with a corner for the Blues. This is another twist in this game. The corner comes in, up they go. Marston underneath and he got his fist to it. A few of the players went out of the box.
Great punch under pressure from Elliot Morris.
They're into 2 minutes of stoppage time. Morgan has it. He maybe can attempt to hold on it. He gives it to Milok. Milok on the run. Linfield push it up. Looking to see, can they get the goal? Or could they bring back their season? This is heart-breaking stuff for everyone involved. The fans are on their feet. They don't know what to do with themselves. The Glens fans, the Linfield fans, the excitement here up beside the director, Fox and Well. It's absolutely amazing. But then again, it depends what club you're from. Heartbreak for one, delight for another. Is there another twist?
The mass exodus now of the Olympic supporters on the far side of the ground.
McArevey with the kick. Milok gets the header. All eyes on the keeper, around the referee now. Chris Morgan holds it up again. He's done that most of the day. Pushes it far now. The
referee's not on his watch.
McCann, the referee's going to the centre circle. He says there's still a few seconds left to play and the Wolf really with the header. Can they do it, or will Glentoran take it a size of lead in the race for the Gibson Cup and for the title? The players are saying time up with Glentoran. The Linfield players are saying referee, play off.
Whereas before, the Linfield player could be 1 or 2 minutes, and might be looking at 5 or 6 minutes overtime. For some reason, I don't think they're going to get that.
And the referee blows the whistle! An amazing game of football here at the Olo. Glentoran with a team. Has been here at the Oval. First of all, Stephen Parkhouse made it 1-0 in 24 minutes. Paul McArevey get back to make it 1-1. Colin Nixon hopped up on 53 minutes. Davey Larmour on 84 minutes. I think we all felt that the Blues had done enough to save it. And then Chris Morgan, hard to believe, the flick and the header. You can't blame the keeper, you can only get a touch in. And Morgan with the touch. 3-2. Hard to take, lead off it.
Pure drama, and you mentioned him coming through there, and how exciting it was. It's a game of passion, and it looked at one stage as if Linfield, through the Larmour equaliser, had maybe done enough. But let's give credit to this Glentoran team. They showed the character that's actually required to be able to sustain a challenge and win a championship. And I watched them in the opening game of the season against Portadown, where they were well beaten by Portadown, but they've gone on and they've won every single home game since then, so they deserve a lot of credit for that.
Some of the fans are on the field, not too happy. And these are scenes we can do without in a local game.
Yeah, no one likes to see this at all. we haven't had this in our local game for the last 10, 15, 20 years.
Well, hopefully common sense will prevail. Noel Bailey and Glenn Ferguson, and he's pushing them back. Yes, get
well
them back.
Well done, guy.
This is
Glenn Ferguson. Yeah,
the Linfield players are out there pushing them back, and that's the way to do it. This is something the local game doesn't need. I thought it's been a fantastic game so far. I see Alfie Whiting out there too to talk to the Linfield fans as well. Glenn Ferguson holding his head. And there's missiles coming off. Yep. We can do without this. Missiles going back and forward.
You know, the players will be so, so bitterly disappointed. And so the supporters, and rightly so. But there's no way we want to see this in the local game. They're letting themselves down, they're letting their club down.
And the Shearers in there manfully trying to push them back, but to be fair, it's only a mindless few.
It is. I think you'll find the majority of supporters are good supporters, and you have the hooligans who attach themselves to both of these great clubs. But this doesn't help. It's been a fabulous game. Okay, maybe the football wasn't the best we've seen at the time, but for excitement and drama, it's disappointing to see.
Yeah, and this is taking away too as well, Lee, from what was a marvellous opportunity for the local game.
It was. We've got a big crowd in here today, and the majority of them, as you said, don't get involved with this, but I think we need to try and maybe get some of the stewards on to remove the five or six people here are constantly just throwing bottles, and you know, it doesn't help our game at all.
Well, there you are. No doubt these will be the scenes that will make the headlines over the weekend, and not the football. Maybe you think that people are throwing into the stand, there's stuff coming back from the stand as well. There's a certain section on both sides of the teams doing it, but that's for another day. The game was 3-2, a fabulous game of football. And what drama at the end, Lee Doherty. 3-2 at finish. You know, they can look at these things. Those people are taken away totally from what was a great occasion. Let's go away home. Get away home. We're not interested in that sort of stuff there. Lee, you take a look at Chris Morgan, the man who got the score. And Glentoran, just about innocent. What do you think?
I think they deserve to win purely for the fact that on two occasions when Linfield got back into the game and had that point that they required, they showed the correct character that they needed. Oh, this is turning into a farce. So, but this is actually spoiling the players' moment, the club's moment. Okay, we're going to go to the final day of the season now, and yes, Glentoran are very much in pole position to take the title, but it's not over yet. Anything can happen. I know Stephen Baxter will have his Crusader squad next week fighting for their life, fighting for the Premiership survival.
And fighting the right way, not like that.
Exactly.
Well, there you have it. A disappointing end here in the Oval. It finished 3-2 to Glentoran. They're now 2 points in front in the Championship. And everything now moves towards Crusaders and Cliftonville next week. But the scoreline, it finished Glentoran at 3, Linfield 2. And now the onus and certainly the advantage slips towards Roy Coyle and the Glen men. Journalists who were conducting interviews there had to get off the field because we have more supporters now on the park. And sadly and unfortunately, these are the scenes and the pictures that will dominate tomorrow's newspapers. This is pure and utter rubbish. This is not what we want to see. Now as fist fights. Look at this here. This is absolutely scandalous. My God of Almighty. This is just incredible. My God of Almighty. And where are the stewards and where are the police? Oh my God of Almighty. There must be six people. And the good people involved in football will be devastated to see this today. The people who have worked so hard to improve the image of the game, who have worked so hard in both clubs as well, and in the Irish League and the IFA, to try and help things. They will be utterly and absolutely devastated by this afternoon. And at long last, the police come on with their batons. So let's see what they will do. And if I was a football supporter, or supposedly a football supporter, I would not be on the pitch at this moment, because I would have thought that the police will soon sort them out. People continue to throw bottles right in front of the police. The bottles continue to fly, continue to break. Lines in there at that gate, over by the Linfield supporters, pushing them back. And it must be said that it was a section of both sides of supporters who were involved in the scenes like that. They can really describe as sickening, unacceptable, and nothing to do with local sport. And you know, after 90 minutes of fantastic football, in that 5 minutes of madness, it has just taken so much away from local sport. And there's even people in that crowd taking pictures with their mobile phones of the violence. You have to wonder about the mentality of people like that who come to a sporting occasion to put masks around their face, to kick people defenceless on the ground, to throw bottles, and then to take pictures of violence going on. There's Jim Rogers, global councillor, on trying to do his bit. Tom Dick, the Glentoran officials, and good Linfield officials as well, trying to get it sorted out. They will want all this sorted out. We had 90 minutes of superb football, a great occasion here at the Oval, and we finish off with police in full riot here at the end of the match.
I've already got that chopper.
And those are scenes of football and sport. There's simply no place for it. Not acceptable, unwanted. No one wants those scenes or those type of people at sporting occasions. Keep the tapes rolling there just in case. Okay. Even though it does seem it was only a small section, you know, but not a small section, there's probably about 100 on either side. Jesus Christ, okay.
Watch your head.
Watch
your head.
Have you got the pictures of them on? Well, that's okay. As long as you have the pictures of them on, just you keep the pictures on. Okay. All right. I tell you what it is, you know this, you see when they're kicking people like that on the ground, you can kill someone.
Oh, Thank you. having it there, yeah. I don't have a radio.
I'm responsible for it.